What is your application? Let me show you first of all the existing application. Just give me 1 minute. So we have worked on file listener, right? Similarly, there is another one called email listener. Email listener, file listener, what is the purpose of file listener? File listener is going to read just now. File listener is going to monitor a folder path. When a file lands, it is going to pick the file, hand over that to another rule called service file. Service file rule is going to open the rule, open the file, read the content of the file, parse it to add it to clipboard, and then process it further the way you want by executing an activity. Same concept when you go out with email listener as well. Based on this file listener, can you tell me how an email listener should work? As it is same like how it is going to be done in case of file listener, the same thing should happen email listener. How email listener should work? How an email listener should work? An email. It's not about pattern. When an email lands into inbox, when an email, it can be anything. So when an email is being received into one of the folder, that can be inbox folder or send, whatever the folder it is, or inside inbox also it can be possible sometimes. When an email arrives at inbox, immediately listener is going to pick the email, hand over that email to another rule called, what is that rule? Service email. Service email is going to parse the contents of the email and then process it. Okay, see, is this same as file listener or not? How it is similar to file listener? In file listener, file will come to a folder. In email listener, email will come to where? Where it will come to? In case when we are working with email listener, file listener monitors folder path. Email listener will monitor where it will monitor. Is this also a folder? Emails also folder or not? Is this similar to file listener? File in a folder in a hard disk. This email is emails also a folder in a hard disk. So when an email lands into your inbox, meaning that an email is also one file. When a file is placed in one of the folder, that folder is mapped to your email application server. Then it will be looking like an email application. You will access the files here also. Everything same. There is no difference. Only difference is it is the file that comes into one of the email server. But in case of file listener, a file comes into normal folder and hard disk. This is clear. So this is about email listener. Email listener is going to monitor a folder path, and then when an email comes, it is going to read that. Now here you go ahead. Let me show you the related rules of email, service email and all. If I am going to open integration resources, email listener. Suppose I am opening this listener. Look at here. In a file listener, you are providing the actual path which it has to monitor. in an email listener, you are going to mention a folder path. That's it. You're going to mention a folder path. So which folder it has to look up. Suppose if it is inbox, inbox. Suppose it is inside inbox, some other folder. Okay. ALS cases. Some folder is there. If you want to monitor that folder, you have to accordingly give the path. Okay. I want to monitor inbox. Whenever an email comes into inbox, for that emails, it is going to create a, sorry, it is going to read that email and then hand over it to service file. Now, the service file rule, let's go ahead and open the service file rule. Integration services, service email, I'm sorry, not service file, service email. Service email. Here you go. So service email is going to receive that email and it is going to execute an activity. So it can be any activity that you create by yourself, it's up to you. But by default, there is an activity that is going to create a case. Okay, work objects will be created for each email. So if the scenario is like when you receive an email, email should be processed to create a work object and attach this email as attachment to the work object. Then this OOTP activity is going to help you for the same. If this is not the case, suppose you want to read the email, read the contents of the email, do some other action, whatever that you want. Accordingly, you have tried your own activity. But leave about writing our own activity. Let's come to this one, how it works. When an email lands in, when an email is being handed over to service email rule by file email listener, then it is going to read all the parameters first of all. What parameters will be there in email? What are the parameters? To
from
CC to from sender name and then subject. The subject. And here you go ahead with body of the email. All this content you read. After this, how would you process this content is up to you. But where this content will be available on clipboard, this content will be available assigned to these properties. These are the properties py inbound email dot py2 py inbound. So these are all OOTP properties. Suppose you don't want this property, you want some other properties. What you should do? You create your own properties and map those properties here. That means it is going to assign the data to all that. On which page it will assign? Which page? What is the page? These properties should be available on some page, right? Ultimately, what is the page? That page is a primary page, that is service page, whatever that you give here. If you go on to clipboard and look up this page will have all the request data. Okay, and this is how, when an email is arrived, PRPC is going to understand the contents of the email, assign reading each of the content parameters on the clipboard to PY inbound email dot PY to PY CC PY from, like this, a number of properties are there. You can use whatever that you want. Remaining, you can go ahead and delete it. Okay. So while you are working with email listener, then file listener, it is very simple. Your email listener, you are not even required to create properties. All the properties OOTP available, you use the same, most everyone uses the same. You want different properties, then you need to change the mapping. Otherwise, no need. Even if you want different properties, after this data is read to primary page, from primary page you can assign to another page by executing your own activity. After the request tab is completed, it is going to execute service tab to execute its own activity. That activity, what will be there inside activity is up to you. See here, the activity what is being called by default is calling a flow. What is the flow name here? PY start case. PY start case is flow for what rules? Case type rules. So whenever PY start case is executed, that is going to call stages, steps, and then processing will happen. So that's how it should work. See, this is okay. I have given inbox is the folder name. I have identified where the properties will be set and what is the activity that gets executed. It can be any activity. But first of all, which email box it has to monitor? What is the email box that it has to monitor? It should know, right? I have 10 email IDs. Which email box it has to monitor? So where should we configure that? In which rule we have to configure the email details? You already know
listener.
This.
Listener.
Your voice is not audible if someone online is saying something. What is the rule that we need to create? This is service email, what I have opened now. Email listener is going to monitor inbox and service email performs the reading of the content and executing activity. What about from email box, where we should define that? In which rule we have to define all this data? We have
email
to define
account.
All that in
email account.
We have to define email account. If you go to email account, here you go ahead. This is the email account rule. We have already worked on this. Did we work on this or not? See, in this email account, you know that you have to provide the sender information while working with outbound email integration, as well as we have mentioned this, what is this? The receiver information also we have mentioned. This is to satisfy the wizard. Wizard will always expect both information to be pre-filled, otherwise it won't work, okay? So like this, you have to mention the receiver information is most important thing here than sender information. Sender information you can make use. Suppose after you receive email, if you want to send back some acknowledgement at all, from the same route, you can use the sender information. Okay. So as when you are working with reading the email content, you need to bother about receiver information first. In the receiver information, you have to go ahead and mention the receiver mailbox and the password and the host name and port numbers and protocols. All this you have to mention. This is clear. So let me take the screenshot and give you. You know how to create an email account? You know how to create or not?
Yes.
I-64-3-R. Sender and I'll mention the screenshot. Receiver. Give me 1 minute. Let me log into the mailbox and see. Because I do not want to use my regular mailbox. If you want to use, you can use, but no problem. Okay, no problem. I'll use my mailbox, no problem. Okay, let's proceed now and we are going to work on email integration. That is inbound. Working with email integration, that is inbound email. So simply let me give this like this, how to create cases using received emails. Okay, so set up an email account like this. Okay, first, okay, we can give, I think we can run a wizard for the same. So we can implement this by using email wizard. Let me do that first. So configure integration email wizard. So what is the purpose that you are going to use this email wizard for? Receive an email, create and manage one, configure an email account. Are you just trying to configure email account? Are you going to do create something using the email integration? Create and manage work object. Is this our application? Ours is? Yes, TFM. Where is it?
First one.
Just give me 1 minute. So before you proceed, because I am trying to create work objects, right? Once the work object is created, I want to route this work object to someone, so that work object will be there in the, I will take approval case or something like that. I'll take a normal flow. You can use PY start case or you can take a normal flow as well. Just give me 1 minute because I wanted to show you in the work list so that you can better understand. We have an assignment here. Make sure it is routed to an operator. What is the operator ID? Manager. Do we have any manager here? STFM MNZR1. Is routed or not? Okay, let me write down what we are going to do. Using this email instantiation, we are going to call a flow from an activity. This activity will be called in email integration wizard. To work with email integration, that is what inbound email integration, right? We need to create below rules. We need to create below rules. What are the below rules? Email listener, email service email. What else? Email listener, service email, activity. That's it. Nothing else, I believe. Flow, if it flow. Okay. Make sure the first assignment of flow, which we are going to call flow, which we are going to activity, is routed to an operator. Any operator it can be. Okay, make sure it should be routed. The below is the flow which I am going to call. Activity. Okay, fine. Here you go. Away. We can implement this by using email wizard. So, Did I give you the screenshot of the same? Okay, whatever the application is, but screenshot is same. System, where is it? Integration, email, email wizard. After you come here, it should be receive an email and then create work, STFM work. And this is framework, right? For us, this flow is available in the framework class flow. I can call from implementation, no problem. And select this one. Which flow? Is that begin insurance? Begin insurance. And would you like to create work? Yes, I wanted to create work object. And what is your organization class? STFM. What is the rule set? Whichever the rule set that you wanted to choose, you can choose. And the version, latest version, whatever that you have, you can go ahead and choose the same. These are the options that we need to select and click on next. Email account name. See, you remember your email account name should always be the name of work class where your flow is available. What is the name of our work class? So this is what email listener name that you are creating. Let's play STFM listener. I wanted to create it like STFM listener. Which folder you want to monitor? I want to monitor inbox folder. Service package. You need to create a service package. Should you have to create or not? While you're working with any listener, any services, should you have to create service packages or not?
Yes.
So service package also need to be created. But here we are not creating service package, because the wizard will automatically create it. Otherwise, if you have an existing service package that fits your requirement, you can choose the same service package. STFM service package, admin package is there. I can choose the same. Otherwise, I'm going to take same whatever that I have got by default. It's up to you. Service class name. What is the service class where you wanted to create the service rules and all? I'll be creating in framework class only. And requester ID. What is the requester ID that you wanted to choose? Means the operator ID. See, any service, when it runs, it should run on some access group and all everything. It should create a requester name. And the requester level access, it will use by requester ID. And requester password is what? Rules. Remember one thing, this is not the email ID. This is operator ID plus operator ID, whatever the password that it has, you have to provide the same. So click on next. Once you click on next, a record with the same name already exists in the database. Service package may negatively impacted as a result of completing this wizard. What is the default email we got? Something like this. Let's see. It may create a new one. Let's see that. But if you use the same also, nothing should happen. But let me see how default it is different from the one which we have selected. So everything it is taking, as an authentication also it is taking. Let's leave it simply. Click on next. So here, account name. You just copy paste the same whatever that you have in place of account name. STFM hyphen, FW hyphen, state form hyphen, work. And select email provider. What is that? Google mail provider, right? What we have is an email address of the sender. Let's say harshabhagavan@gmail.com and password. What is the password? Some password, whatever that you have, and reply to. Reply to maybe harshabhagavan7@gmail.com. I wanted to reply to. You leave it, that's not a big deal here. But here you go ahead. Receiver information is more. Use sender's ID and password. The same I wanted to use, whatever that I filled up. Suppose you do not want the same details, you want to use a different details. Means your receive inbox is email one. Your sent mails will be from email two. If that is the case, you should not select this checkbox. You should go ahead and proceed with different mailbox details. But generally, both will be always same. Wherever you receive from the same mailbox, you're going to reply back to the client saying that the case has been created. And then click on next. And here you see, these are the rules that gets created. The above are the rules that gets created. Okay, let me make sure my workflow is checking or not. It's completed. Okay, so again click on next. So here is final list of rules that gets created. That is for email account, and these are for everything: email account, email listener, and then service package, email, service email. All these are getting created. Click on done. See, once you click on done, here you go. Open the listener rules created. How would you open? Integration resources, email listener. What is that? Allstate, right? This is the one we have created. I'm sorry. STFM. So what you should do here is scroll down, just identify and observe what folder it is pointing to. It is pointing to inbox folder. Just now created. March. Today is 25th, right? It generally taking another time zone. So 25th correct only. Now EST it is 25th, EDT it is 24th. My time is set up like that. Okay, now see, okay, this and all is not okay. Here you go, process tab, data options, save original email. Do you want to save the original email or you do not want to save the original email? Look at here, no attachments. See, if you ignore all email attachments in inline and inline images, you want to only read the content, then this is not required to be selected. Suppose if you want to even read the attachments and images and all and attach to your work object, then this checkbox should be selected, otherwise it is not required. And save original email. If you're going to select this, always attach a copy of original email in some format, whatever the format that you see there, to the work object that they have not written completely. Selecting above option will save the original email as an attachment to work object. This is what going to happen. Sorry, let's go ahead with that now. Save this. This is email listener rule. Open service email. Any one second, hang on. Okay, fine. Let's come back to this later. Service email. This is the service email rule that got created. Service email rule, you'll see an activity. This is most important to understand. See, this one, what it is going to do is, this activity is one of the activity which is responsible for creating work objects. How it will create a work object is, look at here. Called from some other role for email based work object processing. See, this activity is going to call a flow. What is the flow name? Begin insurance that I have given. When this flow is executed, it will allow to create work object selected. So it will create a work object. This activity primary work is to call the flow and process it to create a work object. Once work object is created, we are routing it to somewhere else. So that's it. Suppose if you want to modify this activity, what you can do is, it is OTP activity. What you should do? Save as into your own rule sets, maybe if required your own classes, and do write your own modifications of adding some additional functionality as per your requirement. Okay, so that I'm not going to do now. See, after this is completed, this is done. Okay, now Okay. So once your file listener is completed, did we start the file? Did we add the file listener configured on SMA? SMA means Admin Studio, using Admin Studio. Now, using Admin Studio, start up the listener. Start up the listener on Node. So how to go to Admin Studio? Everything here, what has been created? Fine. I have something to test actually. Let me go ahead and open that email integration wizard and test it before we proceed. Make sure everything is fine. Integration email, email, accounts. And what is that? What is being created now? This one, huh? This one, right? It is success, right? That means email ID, password, whatever I have given is true. So no need to bother much about it. So we'll start it now by going to Admin Studio. Dev Studio, till you start it, it won't create any work objects. But before that, let me go ahead and log into other mailbox. What is the mailbox? Sorry, other operator ID, STFM, MNGR, one password rules. Okay, just to see what work objects are already there. I think four objects are there. Maybe if it creates, more objects should be available here. Okay, so listeners, okay, resources, and then listeners. Once you choose listeners, you will be landing here, the listener page. So now, what listener we want, you know how to add a listener, already we have added that. Select here, select new instance, I'm sorry, start new instance, and then, which one? STFM, where is the listener that we have created? I'm sorry, here we need to select. STFM listener, right? Click on apply. And refresh now. Your listener is started. This is the listener started. Is it running? Not this one. Which one I have created? Did I add it twice or what? This one I wanted. This is running. I think I have clicked on twice, maybe. I'm not very much sure. Is this the same I have added twice or what? Both are showing today's date and time same matching. Okay, no problem. Now, this listener is up and running. Now, this listener is up and running. Now, if you go back to this admin portal and my work, manager portal, it should create cases. Let's see. Let's see once tracing it, whether it is running or not. Harsha Pega 1, right? I have given. Anything I forgot to start up something? No, right? I should not be facing any issues actually. There is some issue. Just let me check once. What is this? Shop close on. This is one of the email I believe. So it should work, right? Info at the red office starts from those data party URI. In 1 minute. Begin insurance, right? It is taking the parties. Give me 1 minute. Let me take another front scenes. Is that FTF from MNZR1 I have given previously? Maybe it is something wrong. Previously, it is not showing a routing option actually. Check this time. The same I'll change otherwise. I'm not going to give the screenshot. I'll restart the listener once. Is creating now, right? Previously it was failing. Now you can see. Okay, if you simply leave it, it will keep on create cases. Okay. Login to man. What is the change I have done? I will give you a screenshot. Login to manager ID. And show and see cases getting created and routed. Okay, let's stop the listener now. Where is it? Let me close everything. Trace and if you keep on leave it, it will create multiple because I have many emails. While you're working, you may work with the name one of the mailbox where less number of emails are there. Once it has read, it will not further read the same email. That's the OTP feature. Okay. Okay, let me go ahead and stop this listener. Did I stop it? Stopping, still it is stopping. Okay, so stop this, done. Okay, so now if you want, after the case is successfully created, if you want to send email notification, okay, how to implement it, I will explain you tomorrow. There is a OTP implementation available for the same, but you need to follow some criteria of when conditions that you need to call in the response tab, which I will give you idea tomorrow. Today you complete this basic template of executing the wizard, but you need to understand and remember py inbound email dot cc bcc subject message body. These properties you should know. Without knowing these properties, even though you work on email listener using wizard, it won't make any sense. Because if you wanted to write your own custom business logic, I mean to say like activity further steps to read subject and display somewhere, something like that, you cannot do it. You will not be able to do it because you do not know what are the OTP properties for which the email is assigning the data after it has been, for which the service email is assigning the data after it has read the email. Okay, so for that you open the service email rule, and go to request tab and make a note of all those properties in your application, okay, in your notebook somewhere. Okay, let me go ahead and give this screenshot of routing again. Did I show you that screen anywhere? Okay. I have not given previously. Your routing you mentioned like this beginning, and then this is the flow. Like this, any flow that you're going to use, you make sure it has been routed first assignment. Can you tell me one thing? Why did I route this first assignment? So that you can easily identify the cases in the specific work list. If you are routed to work basket, you can identify work basket. If it is current operator, what is the requester operator ID? It cannot identify the admin and all. You cannot simply go to admin and see, which will not work. Generally, any business that is created case will be routed. That's why I mentioned routing information properly for our better understanding. Okay, so you can wind up for today. So tomorrow I'll explain you more about email listener. It will not take more than 2 minutes to work on this. I'll explain you that authentication also tomorrow. I will tell you tomorrow. I'll explain you that from email, from property to property, all that, and how we can make use of that body and all. I'll tell you. Okay. You can wind up for today. Thank you for joining. Everyone who has.